everyone. Hope you all having a great Sunday. I am Abhinaya from ThinkTag.
And I am Ali from ThinkTag. Today we will be doing acid-base reactions from C.V. Raman home. Abhi, do you remember in the previous video asking about acid and base reaction?
Oh yeah, I remember that. And I also asked you, is carbon dioxide always a byproduct?
Yes, I'll explain you.
So Abhinaya, I'll explain you the equation.
Okay.
So citric acid plus sodium bicarbonate will produce sodium citrate, which is a salt, and water is produced and carbon dioxide is produced as a byproduct.
Sorry, but I didn't get anything. Can you please show it practically?
Yeah, I'll explain you in a better way.
Are you ready for the practical session, Abhinaya?
Oh yeah, but what are the materials you are using today?
For this activity, we require sodium bicarbonate, citric crystals, lime, bromothymol indicator, water, a glass jar, and a medium sized balloon. So Abhinaya, before we start the activity, we need to make a measuring flask to measure the chemicals what we have for this activity.
Okay.
So for that, for this measuring tube, we'll take a fat straw, a scale, scissor, and tape. So what you do now, take scale, take this fat straw and measure it 5.8 centimeter and cut it. Okay?
Okay.
After that, what you do? You have 5.8 centimeter fat straw, then again measure 1 centimeter, mark it and fold it in this manner.
Okay.
Fold it in this manner. Okay. Take some insulation tape.
How much I cut it? Is this enough?
Yeah, thank you. We'll tape this folded part with the insulation tape.
But here I have a question for you.
Okay,
why are you folding it? Instead of folding, you can just cut it for 8 centimeter and tape it with using the tape, right?
Yeah, if you cut this 1 centimeter and tape it, what happens when you pour salt in this, salt will settle down at this bottom end and attached this to this tape.
Okay,
so to avoid that, we will fold this into 1 centimeter and then we will tape it.
So the measurement will be not correct, what we take, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
And with this one unit of measuring flask, we can measure approximately 2 grams of sodium bicarbonate, 2 grams of citric crystals, and 1 gram of lime.
So this is equal to 1 gram, this straw is equal to 1 gram.
1 gram of lime, 2 grams of citric crystals and 2 grams of sodium bicarbonate.
Okay, for all the, means different materials have different measurements
using
this
straw. Abhinaya, let's start this activity.
Yeah, okay. So Ali, you said you are doing acid-base reaction, no?
Yes.
So how will I know which is acid and which is base?
To find out which one is acid and which one is base, we have two very easy methods to find out them. Okay. So one of the method we will be using bromothymol indicator, and another we will use litmus papers to find out which one is acid and which one is base. So before going to one of the methods, I'll explain what is litmus paper and what is bromothymol blue. Okay, so bromothymol blue indicator is an indicator where we use this to find out which one is acid and which one is base by dropping few drops into the solution we made from acidic crystals or solution.
Oh, will you show it now? How we'll do that?
Yeah, take a test tube. Take 2 or 3 ml of water. Let's try with citric acid, citric crystals. We'll take pinch of citric crystals.
Okay.
Shake it well until it dissolves. Can you see all the crystals are dissolved?
Yeah.
Okay. And now you predict and tell me which color it will change.
No, I don't have any idea.
Okay, so we are using bromothymol indicator to find out whether it is acid and base. Okay.
Okay.
So if this solution turns into yellow or blue, you just predict what is that.
Okay.
I'm adding 2 drops of bromothymol indicator.
I can't see. Can you show it me properly?
Can you see the color change?
Yeah, it's changing to yellow color.
So this indicates that this solution is acidic in nature.
Okay, if you add that bromethyl blue indicator, if it turns to yellow color, then it shows that it's acid.
Okay.
Okay.
Can you pass that, dear?
Test tube
holder. Okay, we have a beautiful test tube holders here. Okay. Now we'll find out which one is base. Okay. For this activity also, take few drops of water. Pour it in test tube.
Okay.
Now we are using sodium bicarbonate. So take pinch of sodium bicarbonate, add in test tube. Okay. And shake well.
Okay. Now we'll add again bromethyl blue to this solution.
Now we'll add bromothymol solution to this drops to this solution. Okay.
Okay.
Now, can you see the color change, Abhinay?
Yeah, it's changing to blue color.
Okay, so this turned into what color?
Blue.
So if a solution turns into blue color, it indicates that it is basic in nature.
Okay. Then sodium bicarbonate.
Sodium bicarbonate is basic in nature, and citric crystals are acidic in nature.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, we have tested sodium bicarbonate and citric crystals. Do you know what water is? What is the nature of water?
Yeah, water is neutral. The nature of water is neutral, right?
Okay, can we find out using litmus paper?
Yeah, we can find it through litmus paper.
Yeah. Okay. So litmus paper are of 2 types. One is red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Can you see that? Okay.
Yeah, blue.
So if blue litmus paper turns into red, it indicates that it is acidic in nature.
Okay.
Okay.
So using litmus paper also, we can check either it is
acid
or base.
Okay. Yes. And if you use a red litmus paper and red litmus paper turns into blue, it indicates that it is basic in nature. Yes. So now take a litmus paper from both the palettes. So you told water is neutral in nature. Let's find out. We'll dip both the strips in water.
Okay.
Can you observe red remains red and blue also remains blue?
Yes.
There is no color change. So it indicates that your water is neutral in nature. So it is not acidic. It is not
basic. Okay.
Very good. We'll keep this aside. In the same way, we'll test our solutions. So Abhinaya, we have tested with bromothymol blue and we have found out which one is acidic and which one is base. So we'll use a red litmus paper, okay, to find out whether it is acid and base.
Okay.
Okay.
So first we'll take the acid, we'll check.
So we'll take acid first. Okay. So I'm taking a blue litmus paper because if blue turns into red color, it indicates
acidic.
Acidic in nature. Nice.
Okay.
Wow. Can you see the color change?
Yeah, it's perfect red color. It's so nice.
It indicates
it's acidic nature.
Yes. We'll also try with base.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll try this.
Yeah.
So let me see which color I'll get.
Wow, that's blue in color.
Yeah. So it's a it's basic in nature.
Yes, yes.
Okay, these are the two methods, like bromethane blue and the litmus papers are those which we can identify which is the acid and which is the base.
Yes.
Okay.
So, in case if you don't have bromothymol indicator in your home,
okay,
you can also use turmeric as an indicator.
Okay, turmeric is also...
Turmeric is also an indicator. So, for that what you do, when you add turmeric powder to a acid, it will remain yellow in color. Or even if it is neutral, then also it will remain yellow color, okay. And if it is basic in nature, your turmeric powder will turn into red color.
Okay.
So what is that? If it is basic in nature, your
it
turmeric
will turn into red, and if it is in acidic in nature, there is no any color change.
Yeah. Okay. So let's start this activity now. For this activity, take a glass jar.
Okay.
Now take approximately 35 ml of water. Okay. And slowly add water to this glass jar. Keep it aside.
Okay.
Then we have made our measuring cups. Okay.
Through this, we'll measure as so acid and base.
So we'll take citric crystals, okay, we'll take 2 units of citric crystals into this water. So 1 unit is equal to 2 grams of citric crystals. Okay, we'll pour 1 unit of citric crystals in glass jar. Okay. And we'll pour another unit of citric crystals in.
So you are taking 2 units of citric acid.
Exactly. Do you know, Abhinaya, where we get this citric acid from?
I think some lemons.
Yeah, all the citrus fruits what we eat are having this citric acid.
Okay.
So in case you don't have citric acid in your home, you can use lime lemon juice instead of citric acid.
Okay.
Now we have put 2 units of citric acid, citric crystals in water. Let's dissolve this. Dissolving. Now easy method to find out acid natured crystals or chemicals is that acid natured chemicals are sour in taste.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, when we
eat citrus fruits, it's
lemon
sour in
juice,
taste.
It will be okay.
Yeah, so you can find out that those are acidic in nature. Okay. To this solution, we have also guessed this is acid or base. So we'll add bromothymol to it and we'll find out what nature it is. We'll add 2 drops.
So it's changing to yellow color. Then it's an acidic nature, as you showed before, right?
Yeah. So this is
acidic in nature. It's turned to blue.
Yes. Now what you do?
Balloon.
I will take a medium sized balloon. To this we'll add two units of sodium bicarbonate, which we also call it as baking soda.
Okay.
Now where will we get this baking soda mostly?
The baking soda will be in home, no? For cooking purposes they'll use baking soda.
Yeah. Can you hold this, open this for me? So Abhinaya, we have filled the balloon with sodium bicarbonate.
Okay.
Now what will you do? We'll put this balloon to this glass jar.
Okay.
And see what happens. Okay. Can you hold this for me? Now we'll gently rise the balloon,
okay.
And we'll make sure that all sodium bicarbonate inside the balloon gets into the solution.
Okay.
And you can also observe something, your acid color changing slightly to light yellow or green or blue. Okay?
Okay. It's reacting.
Yeah, can you see? Can you see the bubble?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you see balloon blowing?
No, I can't see that.
So what is happening here? When you added citric acid and sodium bicarbonate,
okay,
in this solution, carbon dioxide is getting released with some amount of water.
Okay. This is what the reaction is happening, and the gas is releasing.
Yes. Okay. So shake it for a few more minutes to collect. Okay. Now we'll tie a thread to this balloon to store this carbon.
Before that, what all products are formed here through this reaction?
So it is acid-base reaction. So when acid and base reacts with each other, salt, water is formed, and also sometimes carbon dioxide is liberated, and it doesn't. It won't occur in all the equations or reactions.
Carbon dioxide is not released in all the equations.
Some of the chemicals produce carbon dioxide. So we have used citric crystals and sodium bicarbonate. So citric acid and sodium bicarbonates combines to form sodium citrate, water, and carbon dioxide is released. Where you can see this is collected in. Can you see?
This is slightly changing
the color. So before it was?
It's yellow color.
Yellow color. How did we do that? We added bromothermal
blue. Okay, now it's changing to basic.
Basic.
Okay.
So this solution is in what nature now?
Basic in nature.
Okay, you are right.
How many minutes we have to keep this? And what's the time? How many minutes it will take to react?
It will take very less time to take.
It's already stopped reacting, no?
Yeah. Now we can collect this carbon dioxide.
Okay.
Take a thread.
To tie the balloon.
Okay. Can you hold it here? So guys, make this not...
Which gas is present inside in this?
In this balloon, we have carbon dioxide.
Okay, carbon dioxide. But how will you get to know that carbon dioxide is inside?
Yes, to find out that the gas present inside is a carbon dioxide, we have a very simple test.
Okay. So what are you using for that test?
For this test, we'll use lime, which we also call as sunna, chuna, which we use for pan in daily lives. Okay, so this is lime. So what we do, we'll make a solution with lime, we'll filter it, and then we'll use it for test.
So these are the materials you are using?
Yeah, these are the materials which we use to test that the gas present in the balloon is a carbon dioxide.
Okay.
So as I told you, we required lime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what we do, take 30 ml of water approximately,
mm-hmm,
and add 1 unit of this measuring flask cup. Into this 30 ml of water.
Okay.
Okay.
Only 1 unit.
Yeah. And now take the stick and stir.
So I think it forms a precipitation here, right?
This will form a lime solution.
Okay.
And later we will filter it out using a funnel and a filter paper.
Okay.
Now to filter it out, we need to make a cone, filtering cone. Okay.
Oh, yeah. So for it's easy that, to filter
right? the lime solution. So take a filter paper, fold it into half.
Okay.
And make another half.
Okay.
Now open, you can see two halves, open a closed side of paper. Take a piece of tape and stick it.
Oh, so that it should not remove.
Should not be removable. So you'll get a nice cone here.
Okay.
So what you do now, put this in funnel.
Okay.
What we made it from a cut bottle. Take a container,
mm-hmm.
keep it here.
Okay.
Stir this again
mm-hmm.
and pour it in this funnel.
Okay, so it's now, it will get filtered.
Yes.
Oh, now it's becoming full transparent, it's like color of the water.
Yeah, so this solution is still a lime solution.
Okay.
But we have filtered out the slime present in the water because it is not completely dissolved.
Okay.
As we know that lime is a aqueous powder.
Yeah,
which is
yeah. Mm.
Okay, I think this much is enough. Okay, I think this much solution is enough for our test.
Okay.
What we do? Abhinaya, do you want to try this test?
Yeah, sure, I'll do that.
So what you do now?
Guide me so that I'll do the tack.
Yeah, sure. For that, take a dropper.
Okay. Okay.
Take exactly approximately 2.
Oh, now it's a transparent, right?
Yes.
It's a transparent color. Okay.
Open this knot.
Now we remove, so
now we'll carefully put this.
Okay.
Shake it.
I think gas is releasing inside the water.
You can see this white color forming there.
Yeah, white
color. So that's a precipitation. And how is this forming? Lime
okay.
is acting with carbon dioxide and it is forming calcium carbonate.
Which
is a precipitation powder. You can find it here. You shake it little more. You can see the color change.
Okay, now it's becoming, turning to the white color. So
this is a simple test to say that the gas present inside the balloon was carbon dioxide.
Oh,
but
nice.
Did you observe that gas was coming down?
Okay.
Do you know why is that happening?
The gas is... How
it should actually go up.
Yeah.
But the carbon dioxide is coming down and you can see this color change.
Yeah, it's becoming white.
So why is this happening? Because carbon dioxide is denser than air. So carbon dioxide is coming down and the lime solution is acting with carbon dioxide. and calcium carbonate is formed, which we also call chalk.
Which we use in writing on the board. Okay.
And you can also see white precipitation forming, and at the bottom we have calcium carbonate salt, white, few crystals. You can see this precipitation forming inside the test tube.
White color is something is sticky to that test tube. So that's the
precipitation. That's the precipitation.
Okay. Oh, now it's becoming too much dark white it's becoming now.
Yep.
So I think the precipitation is forming there.
Yes. Yeah. So here reaction took place between lime solution and calcium carbon dioxide.
Okay.
And it formed calcium carbonate.
So the product is the calcium carbonate.
Yes, and it is white precipitation powder which we can see inside the test tube, around the test tube inside.
It's forming now, it's forming. Can you observe? See there little bit of particles, little particles.
Yeah, and also inside. Salt is forming at the bottom.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you see that? Yeah. Shake little more.
You see, we can see the precipitation which is inside. See?
Yes.
It's revolving. Nice.
You can see.
So Ali, by doing this stack, I got to know that when acid and base reacts together, it forms neutralization reaction, and its salt and the water is formed.
Yes.
And acid you use as citric acid crystals, and the base is the sodium bicarbonate. So this is really a good activity to do, as you teach with me.
And Abhinaya, this carbon dioxide is produced in the equations where we have carbonates and bicarbonates. So if the equation doesn't have a carbonate and bicarbonate, it doesn't form a carbon dioxide as a byproduct.
Thank you. So let me share an important information with you all, that ThinkTag hosts Raman Awards for the children, that is Raman Young Science Innovator Award. This is to create interest at the young age for all the children, and there is also a prize money of 20,000 at each category. Also, this competition is for teachers as REST, that is Raman Experiential Science Teachers Award. So everyone please participate, and for more information visit ramanaward.org.